Why do people still do this? Makes it really easy for you to stand out though. Recruiters get hundreds or even thousands of resumes for open jobs these days. So how do you stand out among everyone and land an interview? You only have a few seconds to capture the recruiter's attention. Then you need to make sure to turn that into an interview. Let me give you 5 musts of writing a resume in 2021 that will massively increase your chances of landing your next job. Step number 1 is to work on your language. I know it may seem obvious, but I see way too many resumes with grammatical errors and typos. This is way too common and shows you lack attention to detail. Others show they will go above and beyond, and you can't even put your resume through a spell checker. It just simply makes you look unprofessional. When you scan your resume for typos, also make sure you look for repetitive language. We all have a tendency to use the same words over and over and over. Number 2 may be a bit controversial, and it's keep your resume to 1 page. You can accomplish this though by tailoring your resume to the job you're applying for. The same goes for your personal letter. Keep it short and sweet. And this brings us straight to step number 3, which is include a link to your LinkedIn profile. This way, recruiters can dig deeper if they want to know more. Just make sure you put some effort into your LinkedIn profile before you apply for jobs. Make sure your headshot and banner look professional. It's also great to have feedback from 1 colleague for each role you've had in the past. Also, make sure you create a custom LinkedIn link to make it clean and easy to navigate to. Number 4 is to make your resume clear and eye-catching. You only have a few seconds to grab the recruiter's attention, so make sure you make your resume clear and eye-catching. Put the important things at the top of the page. Use bullet points to be clear and concise. You also want to use easy-to-read fonts and don't crowd things. Including a professional headshot will make your resume more memorable. This can be quite important for future interview panels. And finally, step number 5, which is really important, so pay close attention. For previous roles, most people just include a list of things that they did. Why do people still do this? Makes it really easy for you to stand out though. Instead of adding a list of things that you did, tasks, include a list of value that you added at your previous role or the impact that you had. This is important no matter what level of role you're applying for. Include quantifiable metrics if possible. Let me give you some examples to get you started. Instead of writing, develop the budgeting tool, you write, develop the budgeting tool that saved the company X dollars year over year. Instead of writing, created a process to clean materials, you write, improved the process to clean materials, resulting in 50% higher factory output. Instead of writing, restructured customer service process, you write, doubled customer satisfaction by shortening response time by 75%. Make sure you vary the power verbs you use for each of these. Don't use improved or increased, etc. more than once. You want to find new power verbs for each one. When you have changed all the tasks into value or impact added, don't forget to do the same thing for your LinkedIn profile. Those were the 5 steps that you can easily implement today. Feel free to write a comment below if you need some additional help with this. And before we wrap up for the day, let me summarize the 5 steps. 1. Work on your language. 2. Keep it to 1 page. 3. Add a link to LinkedIn. 4. Make it clear and eye-catching. And finally, number 5. Instead of using tasks to describe old roles, use impact or value added. I suggest you open up your resume right now and start making changes. They will definitely increase your chances of getting an interview with your next application. If you want more valuable content like this, please subscribe and I will see you next week. Thank you very much for watching and see you next week.